Well, here's the progress that I've made since the previous segment. It is pretty much all put together. All assembly completed. You can see that I've been doing some putty work. I did not motorize the prop. And here's the little motor from before. In the instructions it said to take a heated end of a screwdriver and put it on the inside end of the prop to, you know, make sure it would stay on. I did that, but I'm not sure if it's the best that I could have done. If I have to take it off, I end up getting a little bit of the plastic here, so I could possibly get it off if I really needed to. But otherwise, yeah, if I don't mess around with the prop too much, it should stay on. And yeah, it's pretty much just do the final paint work, and then it's decals, and it's all done. Yeah. I'll be right back with some decal work on this. Hello, everyone. I am T-Commando. Welcome to part 4, and the final part of the P-51D build series. As you can see, I have most of the decals put on. I am actually doing some decal work right now. If you're wondering why there's two W, Z, and I's in different colors, I can happen to know this. They go on top of each other. Because there's a red... They're black letters with red outline. So you put the red layer on first, and the black. And the same goes for the name of the plane, which is Big Beautiful Doll. Right here. You can't really see the white, but the white goes on first and then the black layer. And then, oh. And there's a few more decals that have got to go on. And then clear coat it to protect them. Because I really want to make sure that these decals stay on the way they are. And yeah, that's pretty much gonna be it. I'll take you through a little bit more, kind of like a story episode. So I'm applying the checkered pattern decals. I actually got the one for the bottom half of the cowl and the top half of the cowl mixed up, so I had to flip them around. And, yeah. There's a little bit of misalignment right there, but I don't think there should be too big of a problem. Yeah. So, yeah, we're getting pretty close to having this finished. Yeah. Oh, and the scorecard thing here, that's also a two-layer decal. So there's a lot of two-layer decals that go on this. And I'll see you after the plane is all finished up. See ya. And this is what can be done in about 20 minutes. After showing you what I'd already had on. I would guess about 20 minutes. So, I got the black letters on. I got the Big Beautiful Doll name decals on. I got the little red outline on. Now, the outline that runs along here, I had to do a little bit of improvisation. They didn't include a decal for that, so I just took one of the other red decals and just cut it up carefully. And I think it works pretty well. Now, you'll notice that the canopy is missing. There is a decal that goes with this, but like I said, I'm gonna put clear coat on this, and I don't want to get clear coat on the canopy. And I have the semi-gloss stuff, which means it's gonna make the canopy look cloudy. Which means I'll also have to carefully mask this part of the cockpit. So yeah. So otherwise, it's pretty much done. After I get the clear coat on this. Is there any, Oh yeah, I still gotta paint these wingtips. There's decals for it, but yeah, they gotta go around a really super curved surface, which is the wingtip itself. And it's I've worked with wingtip decals before. That was before clear coat, and it didn't exactly go well. And so I'm just thinking I'm gonna paint that on myself. Now, according to the decal instructions, this decal is supposed to be on top of the wing on both sides, but that's usually not the case, and I put one right here on the bottom. So that's just kind of my way of doing it. There we go. Decal paper is off. Okay. And yeah, I even put on the prop decals. There's four more of them. So I'll just kind of do those, put some clear coat on this, and then it'll be pretty much ready to receive the fishing line and be hung. And I'll be right back. Well, here's the big beautiful doll, Mustang, all finished up. This Mustang is ready to chase some 109s. So yeah, I pretty much clear coated it and suspended it with fishing line. Looks like from down here, yeah, the fishing line is pretty much invisible. Think I didn't do a bad job on it. It's pretty good. Well, it's been the P-51D build series. I hope you enjoyed that little mini series. I kind of have to do more of those. I enjoy doing the Enterprise. Speaking of which, I still gotta do that repair on. So there's kind of a little bit of an update for you on that. Just waiting for a long weekend to do it. But yeah. Otherwise, the Enterprise is finished. And since it's been. And most of the time, I'm not here in this room. And so it gets cold, and so both the strobe lights work. The starboard nacelle still droops, but I can move it, and those nacelle strobes will not go out. And by not go out, I mean they still flash. So should I do the repair anyway, leave the nacelle drooping, or should I just go ahead, go inside of it? Do the structural repair and fix the wiring. Just tell me in the comments below. Anyway, I'm T-Commando. Thank you for watching this, and I will see you in my next video. See ya.